dog you want to talk about more than the other?
Sure. Well,
the little weenie dog looking thing?
Well, the white one, not the black one.
Yeah.
So, well, first thing I'll tell you is, when I was a kid, I wanted a dog. That's a surprise, I'm sure. All kids want dogs. Wanted a dog so bad.
Are we recording
yet? Yes, we are.
But before we get in, John, we're casually speaking. John, okay.
For John, let's just start it over.
Okay, no, we're good.
Okay.
We can go from here. That's the type of rhetoric they love, I'm sure.
Oh, I see.
Especially if they're transcribing. John, for John Bowe's oral history of Wolf Americans Talk About Their Dogs, I'm with Brian White. This is Jack Talbert, and we're recording an audio interview about Brian and his... He's got more than one dog, but I think we're going to focus on the white-haired, white-haired dog.
Yes, we're going to focus on Mila.
Mila! So here's Brian telling us about Mila and when he decided he wanted a dog.
Okay. Well, when I was a kid, I wanted a dog because dogs are things that kids like. And just like anything that I really wanted in my childhood, rather than actually consult with me, my mom would just get me a bad version of whatever, and that would count. You know, like... Yeah. If I wanted rollerblades, she would get me like $20 rollerblades that you would like get at Kmart. They were garbage. You couldn't use them. So the dog was no different. We got a dog, a very old, very sick dog that one of her friends pawned off on her. And of course, 6 months later, it dies.
Wow.
And
how old were you at the time?
Like 10.
You were 10.
Who gives a 10-year-old a terminal dog? What in the hell? And I was just devastated. And my mom was like, you know what? I don't think we should get another dog. Yeah, if this is the kind of dog you're giving me, lady, this is terrible. So, when I had kids, my kids are now, let's see, 7, 13, 14, and 18. They always wanted a dog, too. But we lived in apartments, we rented, and that pet ownership and renting are not always compatible lifestyle choices.
Yeah.
And it was great because I did not want a dog. And so it was very easy to just put my foot down and say no. And I said, well, if we ever are able to buy a house, we'll get a dog. We bought a house. Mm-hmm. And the kids were like, you know what this means? I was like, you can't remember to brush your teeth, but you remember that we're supposed to get a dog now? Nice.
Yeah.
So my wife was put in charge of tracking down a dog, and she, doing the humane thing and the responsible thing, she went to Craigslist. And I said, this is not a good choice. So we went to shelters and we looked at dogs and we met some dogs, and it was just a painful process because Tina would insist on bringing the kids, and every single dog they saw, they wanted.
Yeah.
And when we'd say no, they'd be just devastated. So I was like, okay. So we went back to the Humane Choice, Craigslist, a good source for all kinds of crazy people, and we found a free dog and worth every penny. We drove up to Mount Vernon to get her, and this dog had spent it was like maybe 2 years old, and it spent most of its life in a laundry room. She was not friendly. She was scared and mean. And she's a little Chihuahua Beagle mix, best we can figure. Mm-hmm. And she didn't like us, and she didn't like the kids.
Yeah.
You know, we get her home, we put her in the yard, and she would sit there and look at you. And she would just turn her head, but not her body. And, like, you could walk around her, she would just follow you with her eyes and not move. And it was like, this dog is not... There's something not right with this dog. And because Tina and I have four boys, she wanted it to be a girl dog.
Right.
Got to get some girl in the house. So Mila is a girl. That dog hated me. I mean, hated me. So Tina would go to bed before me. I'd come in, 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock, and under the bed, she would growl at me. Like, this girl is going to eat my goddamn ankles. And it was scary. She was a scary dog. And it probably took a week or two for her to warm up to me. Uh-huh. And from then on, she's been my dog. She doesn't love anyone but me. And I think it's because she knows who the top dog is. And because she's a girl and I'm a human man. And dogs are man's best friend.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if that's scientific, but it seems like it. So we, she loves no one the way she loves me. She comes to bed with me. She, you know, follows me. And if I try to leave the house without her, sometimes she will throw an absolute fit.
Yeah.
She will bark like crazy, especially if I go out at night.
Right.
It's like, well, everyone else is asleep. She's bored. I got to do something. Take me with you.
Right. Now, why does she show affectionate towards you that she doesn't towards the other people, anyone else in the house?
I think the boys are too needy, and that, she doesn't like that. She wants to do things on her terms.
Yeah.
And they want to pet her on their terms. They want to hold her when she doesn't want to be held.
Oh, yeah.
And I think they don't like that. And as far as Tina goes, my wife goes, I'm convinced that Mila is just waiting for her to die so we can be together.
So Mila's lovelorn for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And if I pet the other dog, Mila will get very upset. She'll look at me like, how could you do this? And if you pick up the other dog, she's like, nope, you have to pick me up too. And my cousin said, when we got the dog, she said, one dog is a lot of work, two dogs is less, because they entertain each other. So we did get a second dog and found that to be true. And the second dog is a sweetheart. When they're together, she's not as nice because she thinks she's supposed to act like Mila.
Right.
And she's not.
Oh. So Mila brings the other dog down, makes the other dog's behavior degenerate.
Yeah, she's a bad influence. And Mila is big enough that she's managed to jump out of the yard once.
Because
at the front of the yard, we have a half-height fence.
Yeah.
And in the corner, there's a rock. And if she jumps up onto that, we had to put a kitty gate around the rock to stop the dog from getting out.
So the kids are okay. You had the kitty gate for the dog.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and our neighbor's like, why do you have a child gate in your yard? So I know.
So what's one of the funniest things that you've seen this dog? What's one of the funniest things that Mila does or has done?
So a fun thing, my wife thought it would be fun to teach the dogs to speak. What she hasn't been able to teach them to do is shut the hell up. So one thing that's fun is if you're eating, they will beg for food. And the reason they do that is because all of the boys give them food.
Oh, yeah.
The first week we had her, Max fed Mila a half pound of bologna. That was a disaster.
A half a pound of bologna?
Yes.
The dog, how much does the dog weigh? 2 pounds? 10 pounds?
It's about 14.
14 pounds?
Yeah, so.
That's what?
The 10 pounds of bologna?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a substantial amount. So, yeah, that'd be like us eating four to five, 10 pounds. Yeah, a lot.
Yeah.
And she, oh, God, it was a mess. Anyway, so you sit down on the couch. You've got your food. And my wife loves to not finish her food. I don't know what her deal is. She will not clean a plate. Whether it's got 3 things on it, she'll eat 2. If it's got 100, she'll eat 98. But she won't finish her goddamn food. And she does this with everything. We've got probably 8 different shampoos in the shower.
Oh, yeah.
All of them almost empty, but not quite.
Yeah.
Can we throw them out? No, they're not empty. Oh, for fuck's sake. I can't get in the shower anymore. So, we've got, without exaggeration, 6 half-used tubes of toothpaste.
Mm-hmm.
6? What the hell are we doing with 6 kinds of toothpaste? Anyway. So, she'll sit down, she'll eat her lunch, and she'll have a couple pieces left on her plate. And one dog will come from each side. You know, it's a sectional with the armrests on it.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll have a dog on one armrest and a dog on the other. And they'll stare at the plate. And they'll get closer and closer. They'll inch in until each dog is maybe 8 inches away from the plate with their nose. And they start looking at each other. And if you want to rile them up, you put your face 8 inches and look at the food, and they'll start growling at you and talking to you. I've got a video of it on my phone. I'll show you later. But it is, and there's, and they talk. They just, oh, God. And if you talk too, if you growl, oh, my God, it's on. They will go insane. Because they honestly think, it's like, you dogs know that I have access to the refrigerator, right? I know how to work the can opener.
Right.
That's my use around here. Yeah. These dogs are so spoiled on human food that if you go to the drive-thru at the bank and they give you a dog treat, they will not eat it. Hmm. They will, you hand it to them, they'll like smell it, and they're like, that doesn't smell like a Cheez-It or a piece of hot dog.
Yeah.
It's none of those things. I'm not interested. Hmm. They will sometimes, though, eat the puppuccinos that Starbucks will give you, where they put a little
whipped
cream in a cup or a lid. They do enjoy that.
So what's the meanest thing you've ever seen the dog do? When has the dog been... and you gave me the indication, I don't think that we talked about it here yet, but you gave me the indication you think the dog was stuck in the laundry room, but also possibly abused, maybe physically abused.
Yeah, it's tough to say. You know, she is, when we got her, it was clear that she had been mistreated. Her behavior was so bad, and it's gotten so much better, that we can tell this is not just who she is. This is, you know, it was a learned behavior. And she, we've always said, if she ended up in a shelter, she wouldn't get out.
Yeah.
She would never get out, because she's never bit anyone. She'll nip at you, but not bite you. She might bite your clothes, but not you. And she'll play bite, but again, but she's loud, and it's enough to scare you. The only kind of stores I've been able to successfully take her to would be like the hardware store, because they allow non-service pets. And when I take her into stores like that, I keep one hand on her at all times. And I might lock my thumb under her collar just so I know where her head is. Because people will walk up and try to pet your dog without permission.
Oh, yeah.
And she ain't having it. That's a dumb idea.
Yeah.
Do not pet a stranger's dog without permission.
Yeah.
Unless you're a fan of rabies.
Yeah.
So she... and some people will come up and say, oh, can I pet your dog? No. Oh, but dogs love me. I'm just telling you, don't do it. Oh, look here. See, she like, nope, lady, you're gonna. And then, rough, rough, rough. I mean, the whole store is echoing with this tiny dog's obnoxious barking.
Yeah.
And, yeah. When she barks, she doesn't bark for fun. The other dog is just a yapper. She'll just yap, yap, yap. Mila barks. It's intimidating. So the meanest she is, I would say, is anytime someone comes to the house, even people she knows very well. My oldest son has a caregiver that comes in 5 times a week, barks at her every time. It could be because my dog's a racist, but a lot of dogs are. I don't know if that's it or not. But
so on the funniest thing you've seen the dog do.
So the dog is incredibly dumb. So I had never realized until I had these dogs. So in the last couple years, I had never realized that the names of dog breeds correspond to what they do.
Okay.
It had never occurred to me. So I was explaining this to my cousin. I said, it's insane. You take the ball, she goes crazy.
Yeah.
You throw the ball, and she watches you do it, and then looks back at you and barks. So she's barking at me. I'm like, not me, the ball. She's like, okay, I'll go bark at the ball. And then maybe she'll pick up the ball, and you're like, great, bring it back. I'll throw it. She's like, forget that. You threw it last time. I'm not chasing balls all day. My cousin said, well, of course not. She's not a retriever. I was like, oh, for crying out loud. And I get it. I get it now. All the damn breeds correspond to what they do. Yeah, and she is not a retriever. If you were early man, the only purpose this dog would serve is as an early warning system. That's it. Because she would not be good at hunting or any useful task.
Hang a couple of around the entrance to the cave.
Yeah, yeah. Put them out there like cement lions in front of a Greek house.
So, the thing I was thinking about, because we don't have a dog in our house, we actually my wife has dander allergies,
mm-hmm.
and so she's had to take medicine whenever she's around. Anything, and everyone always has a dog that doesn't shed, but they shed.
Right. It's not the hair that she's allergic to.
Yeah.
The dog still has skin.
Yeah, yeah. So when we moved into...
Although you could try to get...
skinless...
Yeah, and just, you know, remove the skin, replace it with, like, plastic wrap so that keep the moisture in. I don't recommend that.
But anyhow, so one of the things that you were talking about that isn't a... hasn't been a consideration for me because I haven't had to deal with it. Strangers just approach you on the street and say, "Let me touch your thing."
Whatever. Oh, right.
So I want to touch and fondle the your animal here, mm-hmm. the thing like that. So, but does that? I mean, does it help to build a relationship and it's an encounter that you want, or is it a detriment that you're like people come up to you and you say, "I don't. If I didn't have the dog, you wouldn't have accosted me anyway." So you're coming here, say, "I want to pet the dog." But I didn't want you to approach me to begin with.
I like strangers.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them have candy. Some of them have cool vans with murals on the side. I don't mind it. We were at Lowe's a while back, and this lady came in with her, I forget the breed, but it's a famously large breed. It's not a St. Bernard, but it's English something.
Yeah.
And we looked at it. I mean, this thing was a friggin' bear. It looked like a bear.
Oh, yeah?
It looked like she was walking a mini bear. And I was like, "I'm sorry, I have to ask about your dog." And I think she said it's 145 pounds.
Wow. That's people. That's a human.
Yeah.
That's a full-grown human-sized dog.
Yeah. And she said the dog is very friendly. You can pet her and all that. And as we're standing there petting her, two other people end up in the same conversation as us. How big is that dog?
Mm-hmm.
Because it, and you know, the lady was very friendly. Apparently she's used to this question.
Yeah.
I would not want to clean up behind that dog.
Yeah. Get the little scooper's regular size shovel.
Mm-hmm.
Need an entrenching tool.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A snow shovel just dragging across the carpet. It's got a nice flat angle to it.
Almost worth investigating diapers for the dog at that point.
Well, that's why you have to house train them. Oh, God. And our dogs do not... they love not going to the bathroom outside.
Huh.
They just love it. Because the kids... Oh, God. It's... You just have to let them out a couple times a day. That's all you have to do. And the kids just space out or get lazy or whatever. So Tina, rather than properly train the dogs, has all these insanely complicated workarounds that don't work.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she bought plastic runners for the carpet.
Yeah, okay.
All that does is make them louder when they walk. It has changed nothing. Sometimes she'll fence them into the kitchen at night. It's like, now I'm just concerned they're peeing in the vent.
You ever have that? Because I did have dog. I had a little dachshund, mm-hmm. a long time ago. But I remember one time getting out of bed and thinking the carpet's really warm.
Oh.
But it's hardwood floor.
Oh.
I was like, why is it soft and warm? It's like, oh, that dog. But
that really soaks into the grain.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's a rug. It's a different house, but when I'm assuming the rug's probably still That rug's still probably over that spot where it's been since, I don't know, 91 maybe? Mm. It's been a while. Mm. It's been back there. So, have you ever, is there ever been a problem with the dog? Like a discipline problem where you have to be corrective, take the dog out, do something?
Not really. Sometimes she will be overly aggressive with the boys. Mm-hmm. But in every case I've seen, it's because they weren't being respectful of her. Mm-hmm. They were being too aggressive with her, or, you know, there was reasons. She knows when she's in trouble. If you find a turd in the house, you can tell which dogs is which by size, because the other dog is half her weight and has correspondingly small poos. Mm-hmm. Did you make that mess? Her ears go down, her tail goes down, she walks away in shame. Other behavioral problems? Not really. No. When I wake up in the morning, it's fun. She likes to. If I get up in the morning, I'll get on my phone, and she will, you know, kind of climb on top of my chest. Mm-hmm. And if I say, well, it's time to get up, she'll climb on top of me like a goat. Yeah, she's more of a goat than a dog, really.
So dogs talk to their owners. Do you feel like you have a rapport set up, that you have a language that you understand? That I had one guy that he said that the dog would come and beg for food, come up and beg for the food. And he'd say, we have no food. There's no more food. Take the dish and show the animal the dish and say, look at the dish. There's nothing left on the plate. There's nothing. But they would clap their hands together and wipe them 2 times real quick, kind of like that motion.
Yeah, the Vegas move.
Yeah, the Vegas move. And
I do that with her as well.
And as soon as the dog saw that, it believed the food was gone and quit and went on with her life.
Yes, I also will do that. I'll show her the plate. I will do the Vegas move as well. Mm-hmm. And yes, that is when she knows there's no food. When we go outside, there are 3 commands: inside, yard, and car. I'm not sure she understands any of those words, because because I'll say inside, and I'm not. I think she just follows me, because they'll always run out to the end of the driveway. There's a shrub that all the neighbor dogs love, so they have to go out and check it out and see who's been by. Mm-hmm. And yeah, in terms of the car, if you open the car door, because we've got the remote on for the van door, if you open that, they know that means it's time to go. Another thing with Mila is she's very good at knowing. Sometimes even before.
Hold on just a second.
Sure.
Hold on.
Sure. What was I just saying, though?
You were talking about how you show them.
Oh, the languages.
The dog has no inside from outside from.
Yes, there was.
What was it? Inside car, house?
Inside yard and car.
Okay.
Yeah, she knows sometimes even before I do that I'm going to leave. Because apparently one thing I will do before I leave that I hadn't even realized is I will stand at the top of the stairs looking out the front window.
Uh-huh.
And when I do that, she's like, oh, he's going. And she'll start wagging her tail and maybe growling a little at me. Talking, not growling, but yeah, she'll know. And if I put my shoes on, oh my gosh, she'll go insane. Oh my gosh, take me with you. And yeah, she likes to. Some dogs, like Melissa's dog.
Uh-huh, yeah.
I'm not entirely convinced it's a pet or a hostage, because if you open the door and it takes off, that's a hostage.
Yeah, yeah.
Tina will say, oh, don't open the door. The dog, you know, Tina, the dogs don't want to go outside unless we're outside. The reason why, when we come home from the store, when we open the door, that they run out is to jump in the car because they think we're going to leave again.
Yeah.
And they'll do that. We're unloading the groceries and they're sitting in the car looking out the window. Let's go. Come on. Time to go. They're not smart dogs.
So if you had to give a eulogy for Mila, what's in the eulogy? What's the thing that you would want everyone to fondly remember about this? I actually, before that, I guess I had another question. When did you decide that that was going to be the dog? You said that you found the dog in the laundry room and then you took the dog home. What happened in between? What were the in-between steps?
So, no, it was... The dog was posted on Craigslist with very few pictures. I mean, the pictures, you really could, all you could tell is it was a dog. They were like the worst photos you've ever seen. And it was free. And we asked, why is it free? And they said, because she's... Yeah, they danced around it a bit to basically say that she's not a good dog. And that was basically it. We said, yeah, I guess we'll come up and take a look at her. And if she doesn't bite us, we'll take her. And I said, is this your only dog? Yes. I said, do you want to get rid of some of your dog? Do you have any other dog's shit you can give me?
Yeah.
And so she gave us a bunch. She gave us a little cage. Mm-hmm. And I mean, this cage, I'm confident, was, you know, her home. Mm-hmm. So we had the cage and, you know, some treats and a half a bag of dog food and basically when we met her, she just basically handed us the dog, handed us the stuff and left. Like, well, I guess we have a dog now. And after that long ass drive, my God, to drive all the way up there for nothing. But instead we got an angry little monster. On her collar, when we got her dog tag, we wanted, we put it all into the computer at Petco or whatever. And so we put her.
Instead of warning, a little warning light come off, it was a, this dog's been flagged.
Well, so we put the information on the front, her name and our phone number. And then it said, what do you want to put on the back? We're like, the back? Do not feed after midnight.
Don't get wet. Don't feed after midnight.
Right. We put on her tag on the back. It says, do not feed after midnight.
Huh.
And the other dog, we decided to continue the tradition. Her tag says, for external use only.
So, but you took the dog because you didn't want to have the drive back with an empty car and have...
And angry kids. We had already decided before we got there that... Literally, as long as the dog doesn't bite us, we're taking it. And we're glad we did because she would have been a difficult project for anyone. And I think if it wasn't us, she wouldn't have made it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's good that you invested the time to save that. They say the animals have insightful eyes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like this, you know, tortured animal trapped inside that dog's body, and you have to help.
Mm-hmm.
help the dog to become better.
I would agree.
Yeah.
So there was the next question about the eulogy thing.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what would you do on the eulogy now that we know how the dog came into your life, if, you know, heaven forbid that well, I don't know, I mean, it's half of one, six does the other, because you know you're probably going to outlive the dog, but you don't want to think about outliving the dog. But then if you don't outlive the dog, then you're just praying for an early death for your own demise.
Which I do, you know. Which I definitely, that's definitely me.
Is your hope not to outlive your dog?
I want my dog to mourn me. Yeah. I want to hear her eulogy.
Yeah.
I wonder, a lot of times I wonder what they're thinking. Because you look at them, and sometimes the thought process is very clear. Like when they're inching towards your food, you know damn well what they're doing.
Yeah.
Actually, another funny one I just remembered. We had dinner, and quick, we have to go to get to the movie or whatever. Go outside. Oh, we forgot something. Open the door, and Mila's standing on the table licking the plates. And she looks up, and she's like, oh, shit, I'm caught. Yeah, get off the goddamn table. You have to remember to push the chairs in, or
yeah.
So, in terms of what, so yeah, I hope to outlive my dog on account of, you know, dogs not living very long.
Yeah.
And I've looked it up. A lot of people, a normal expectancy is apparently only like 10 years for a dog.
Yeah.
And she's already halfway there. Mm-hmm. Where does the time go? Because she was 2 when we got her, and that was about 3 years ago.
Yeah.
So, hard to think. In another 5 years, she'll be gone. That's crazy.
And some dogs live up to, you know, 17 maybe.
Yeah.
I think the oldest cat that I saw that was verifiably recorded was like 24.
Yeah, I've seen a cat approaching 20.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the groomer would no longer work on it because I'm going to break your goddamn cat. This poor sad old thing. So I, hope. What would I want people to remember about my dog?
Yeah.
Nothing in particular. You know, what can I say about her? She's nice to me. She's loyal to me. She's not a nice dog. She's not a loyal dog. Unless you're me. Which, for me, works out great because I am.
Is she protective of you? Possessive? And
she's possessive. Yeah. I don't know. I can't tell if she's protective of me, but, you know, she barks at everyone. I assume that's being protective.
Yeah.
But I don't know if that's protective of me or just, or if she's just kind of a bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, technically, literally, yes, but.
Yeah. Yeah, is that also her personality?
Right.
Disposition like that?
Yeah.
So, if not Mila, what other dog do you think you would have had, or is this the only, is it, and that was your first dog?
Yes, my first dog, other than Cinnamon, who was a old, sick shit factory. So the other dog, if not her, well, we ended up getting another dog, and this time we decided to get a friendly dog.
Mm-hmm.
So we did the humane and responsible thing and went back to Craigslist and bought a dog. This is the kind of dog that you have to pay for because she's worth it.
Yeah.
So we drove down to Tacoma, met her at a dog park, and Pepper was maybe definitely under a year. She was not full grown by any means. She was very little and very cute. And she hadn't been fixed yet because she was still too young.
Mm-hmm.
So she is just the most adorable little thing you've ever seen. Well, she's a 9.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want a dog that's a 10. Those are a grooming nightmare.
Yeah.
She's so cute that when we took her to the vet to be fixed, they put her up on Facebook as the pet of the day.
Hmm.
And there was, you know, 20, 30 pets there. So she's best in show. She's a cutie.
Hmm.
And she's very affectionate and lovey and polite, but I don't think she gives a shit about any of us. I think she's just nice in general and doesn't really have a bond with us. I think if we sold her or gave her to another family, she'd be totally fine with that.
Mm.
As opposed to Mila, who would be devastated.
Well, Ryan White saying, if you got to have a dog, make sure it's a 4 to a 9. And, so I guess the best way to summarize the dog is Mila is a good dog if you're me.
I would absolutely agree with that.
Okay, well, I think that'll wrap for now, Brian. Oh, yeah, that is such a nice...
For some reason, the coat swaddles her and she won't move. She just freezes. The hell?
I got it.
Oh, I see. I've got the. Gotta turn this off so I can have. Here we go. Uh. the Do Not Disturb turned on, and for some goddamn reason, it won't let me turn it off. Turn on now. Yes? What the... Ah, okay. For fuck's sake.
Show me some love.
So that's her.
Show me
wrong one. Here you go. That's what she looks like if you can trick her into smiling.
Yep.
Oh. The trick, and I don't know how...
Here's the dogs trying to get the food.
Why the fuck can we not hear it? You can see.
Yeah.
Where's the fucking sound?
I don't know.
Why the fuck is there no sound, man?
No. Must be on the Do Not Disturb.
So anyway, yeah, that's the dog.
Yep. Yeah, I remember that we, I think, Owen played with probably Pepper at the...
I would assume.
Dom's birthday.
I would assume.
Yeah.
Yep. All right, I'm going to turn this